Your SDSU soccer team is atop the Summer League standings after a weekend which saw them go 1-0-1. Lang Wiedemeyer's squad drew a 3-3 tie Friday night at Fort Wayne.
Yeah, we talked a lot about trying to start better in games, and I thought we did that against Fort Wayne. We got a goal early on. Torrey Poole got our second goal of the season, and really nice setup for us, and kind of felt like we were going to get things going. But to Fort Wayne's credit, they came back. And we had a couple lapses. They made us pay for them, and next thing we knew, we were down 3-1. So, the girls have shown a lot of resiliency all season, and Lauren Kresak got a goal right before halftime, her first collegiate goal, and that really gave us a little bit of momentum going into the second half. Diana Potterfeld tied it up on a corner kick to make it 3-3, and we felt like we were really going to get that winner and kind of get out of there with a result, and had some great chances to do so, but just didn't go our way.
The Jacks returned home from Fort Wayne to play returning Summit League member Oral Roberts on Sunday. A well-balanced attack led the Jacks to a 3-0 victory.
It was certainly an odd weekend to be able to play at Fort Wayne, then travel back to Brookings and play at home. Oral Roberts was supposed to play at University of South Dakota on Friday. That game got rained out, and so they were fresh coming into our game on Sunday. So I was really proud of our players for starting the game off well, getting a goal in the first half, managing the rest of that first half well, and then really kind of putting the game away with two more in the second half.
The victory was Wiedemeyer's 100th win at the Division I level.
Well, I really need to say that I've been blessed to have been able to work at a place like SDSU for so many years and to have coached so many great players through the program. That's really what makes it special. I'm probably less concerned about the overall wins and more about what we do this Friday and this Sunday. But it's been an honor to, as I said, have worked at South Dakota State, to have coached so many great players, to have seen the program grow and change and mature over the years. So that those are the most rewarding things.
So now SDSU heads into the final stretch of its season, and the next three games are on the road.
This is definitely the toughest portion of our conference schedule by far. Playing at North Dakota State on Friday night, obviously it's a big rivalry game for us. And then we've got to travel down to Omaha for Sunday. And again, the way the schedule works out, they don't play on Friday. So, you know, we've got to not only travel, but play two fresh teams. So it's certainly going to be a challenge for us, but we're excited about the games.
And when you look at the conference standings, SDSU sits on top at 3-0-1, but parity persists throughout the rest of the league.
Right, there is a lot of parity. You know, last year Denver kind of ran away with things, and they're still very good, but teams are now matching them, and every game is tough. Every game you have to give your best, and you have to find a way to get results.
And Wiedemeyer says the key to continuing the success is?
We've got to be able to win on the road, something that's been a little bit difficult for us at times this season, and that's what it's really going to come down to.